Hello everyone, this is Injamam and welcome to Injamam Study Hub. In the last video, we have discussed about some basics of right to property. Today, I will give you an extensive study on right to property. The two more important factors of right to property, that is the concept of compensation and the concept of adverse possession associated with right to property. Let's discuss the concept of compensation. In earlier lesson, we have discussed that the right to property now is a legal right. The government can take over your property making a parliamentary law. But remember, it is by making a parliamentary law, not by a notice, not by a notification. For example, if there is a property, that property belongs to you. If the government needs that property to make a flyover in public interest and the government issues a notification, if you agree, that will be fine. If you do not agree, you can definitely go to the court and fight against the government of the possession of your property. But if for the same property, government makes a law in parliament or passes a law in parliament, then the court will not interfere it. That you have to leave the property to the government in public interest. So suppose the government makes a law in the parliament and take over your property. So, is it necessary to give you the compensation for that property? No. Compensation is not necessary, except two conditions. That is, the compensation is necessary if only the property was of minority institute guaranteed by Article 30. And number two, the property was under personal cultivation land guaranteed by Article 31A, which was added by First Amendment 1951. That means, in two conditions, if the property was of minority institute or it was under a personal cultivation land act, which is mentioned in 31A of article. So, in these two cases, the government is bound to give the compensation. So, this is a concept of compensation in right to property. Now, come to the adverse possession. What is adverse possession? Adverse possession is based on occupation of land. Basically, adverse possession is related to acquisition of land. If someone occupies your property for 12 years and in a span of 12 years you have not made any complaint or any case, file any case against that individual person who has occupied your land for 12 years, in between the 12 years you have not made any complaint to him, then after 12 years you lose its ownership. So that means the land will belong to that person who has illegally occupied for up to 12 years. But this method is not applied to the government. That means the government cannot use this method to take over your land. For example, there was a case 30-40 years back in Himachal Pradesh. That means the government occupied the land of an individual and the individual did not know about the adverse possession. An individual thought that if the government wants, then government can take any of the property of any person. So when the case went to the court and then the court declared that adverse possession is not applicable to the government, that means the government cannot use this method of 12 years possession to take over your land. So this is a concept of adverse possession. in right to property. And I hope that I have given enough information regarding right to property. And this lesson are basically designed for objective based. That means for objective type questions or statement type questions. I'm putting here the concept as well as the data, which will help you. And for the subjective type or for the writing skills, I'll bring another lesson after, that means completing the series of objectives. So see you in the next lesson with a wonderful topic, and have a good day.